Hey, welcome to Cyber Safe. If you are new to this channel, please and please please just click the subscribe button right now. Please and please click the subscribe button right now to get notified when we upload new content. And don't forget that notification bell. Just click on it, then click on all. It will help you get notified when we upload new content. A friend of mine got chatting with a scammer who wanted to scam in relation to bet. So I know most of us play, we use SportyBet, NigeriaBet, BetKing, and all any betting platform that we know, both here in Nigeria or abroad, wherever it is. But you need to be careful most times. You can see links telling you to you get free odds, you get sure games, and all those kind of things. And the moment you click on it and then click on the link and put your account details, you might get phished or scammed. So let me just watch this video. You will see more of what happened. It was a very funny incident.
So it first started. Good evening, sir. Mr. Andrew, I got your number from Olushu dating app. I'm giving out SportyBet live matches for payments after winning. All you have to do is create a SportyBet account and deposit at least 500 naira within 2 to 4 hours, you are sure of winning up to 350,000. If interested, you notify me immediately. 350,000 naira, and this guy can open multiple SportyBet account by himself and get 350,000. He's saying you are sure. Guy was like, Olushu dating app, care which one, please? Said all you have to do is create a SportyBet account and deposit at least just 500. Now the question this guy even asked was not in the scammer's mind. His doing is just, oh yeah, it's time for let's get into business. It was not like, I have a SportyBet account. This was not like, okay, make a deposit of just 500. See, the only thing, he didn't even answer the question. What is in his mind is just, oh yeah, hurry up and let me scam you. I was like, okay. He now sent the real SportyBet website, which is SportyBet.com. So the guy was like, I already have 500 in it. Then he said, okay, hope I can trust you with my games. This one was not playing along because he already knows that SportyBet can just approach him that way. He was like, okay, 100% you can trust him. Like, okay, ready to get your games now? Imagine. These people are really funny because people, you get to see all these things, and some people, for this guy to still be doing this, it means for some people are falling for these scams. Those people that bet, some of them are falling into this scam. Okay, now I said, hope it is booking. I said, here's the SportyBet company link. Make sure you log in correctly with your SportyBet valid details, phone number, and password, and get your games. Select 100 to 200 odds, okay? And then he sent this link. A Weebly domain. Like, this is not even SportyBet, this is not relating to SportyBet at all. So this is a red flag. Once you see this kind of link that is not even from SportyBet, you should know. Notify me once you've gotten your game. Select the 200 odds available. SportyBet live matches does not activate booking code. You can see how, though it takes someone that is already aware of all these things to easily figure this out. I find it difficult. So the guy was still playing on. I'm finding difficulty in locating some teams. So where are the games? Where are the games, sir? And I said, click on the link. He's still insisting he clicks on the link. So there's this thing in cybersecurity they call when someone is insisting, urgency, is putting urgency into the whole thing that they say, tell him to click the link. So he wants him to be quick and then so that he can get the details. So he said, click on the link, fill in the forms correctly, select the 200 odds available, then click on submit. No time. And the next page, you select just two matches. So all those other ones are formalities. What he just needed for this guy to do was to click on the link. And once he's done clicking on the link and putting those details, straight up. And I said, if your details are wrong, no games with you. See, lies. You just want him to put in the right thing. So these are social engineering tricks. They just say all these things so that you fall for it. The link will just lead you back to your SportyBet account to cross-check your details. Cross-check your details correctly, especially your password. Like, this person self is not really a good scammer. Like, how do you make these things very obvious? Though maybe it's for me. For this person to still be doing it, it means he's getting people and he has gotten so many people.
So as you can see, the website, even the link itself, is saying SportyBet's freeoffer.weebly.com. So it's even telling you the domain itself or the website name is showing that it's hosted by Weebly. It's not an owned domain. It's not from SportyBet. So you can see it's hosted by Weebly. So the person just created a quick Weebly site to run this scam. Just look at its fastest payout and look at how crafted it is. It's most people will fall for this. Those that don't really know anything about about being cyber security safe or online safe, without looking at links, some people would have clicked it. Just look at it. Make sure your account is funded up to stake the odds you're about requesting, and you are a registered member with SportyBet. He wants to make sure you have a SportyBet account then, and he said make sure your account is funded so that you have enough money, so when he ends up hacking your account, he can use the money inside for whatever purpose he wants to. Now, said note, this offer is only available with those with such terms. English stuff is sad. So that's all someone needs to get into your account, and that's it. Then amount of odds in there, all these ones are just formality. The main thing the person wants you to do is just put your phone number and your password, and once you click submit, the person has it. So we just need to be careful. This is even funny because for him to have tried this for the person and the person didn't fall for it is because the person knows what's up. The person knows that it's not supposed to click on links and he needs to be careful. The person that sent this kept on hammering on or insisting on clicking the link or putting the details, which was kind of obvious. So all the social engineering tactics are, if you are cyber security conscious of, you know about online safety, you know that you don't just click links like that. You look at the link first. If it's looking all shady, don't click on it. You can even copy the link and then scan it with Virus Total or all these link checkers to check the correct link or if the site is valid. You can even go to SportyBet. If it was something legit, you go to SportyBet.com, which is their normal website, and then check it out.